Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Benson just lied to me.
I did.
I thought we were friends. What the relationship we've built.
I feel like it was all a dream.
I can't even take you right now. Well, either way, thankfully, your action will be made up for by this next matchup. We got TK versus Noble Impact. Noble just came off that tough loss there to Optic Gaming 3-2 in round 11, game 5. Matt and I were speechless afterwards in the analyst desk. But, Ben, we're going to be hopping into Hardpoint on Solar here. Now, what are going to be the keys to victory for both these squads?
To be honest, the big thing I feel with Hardpoint in this game is decision-making.
Yeah.
We've seen this weekend so many times teams just not really make the right decision when it comes to challenging hills with not a lot of time left on them. Obviously, in broadcast, we can't see exactly the right amount of time on the Hardpoint, which is kind of annoying, I'm not going to lie. But
now, Killa starting off with a thermal sniper if you want to switch to him.
Wow. All right, Killa.
Sitting up top here. He did this against OG.
Right. I feel like this is his kind of go-to start when it comes to hard points with open hills. He's actually going to draw first blood there as well for himself and pick up some extra points. Anyone using anything else interesting?
Quickly scrolled through. I saw only 8 EXO overclocks, so no crazy EXO abilities. Actually, 7 since Killa's not using an EXO ability.
Yep.
Outside of that, nothing too crazy. I expect to see possibly trophies used in this game inside that back garage hard point as a lot of nades get chucked in there. But as you can see, both squads playing for this scrap hill here as neither squad really getting too much of an advantage. The man right now, though, Killa, starting off 5-1. He's having a great tournament so far.
Yeah. Oh, Theory actually using a trophy system now, so he switched his class out.
See, there you go. And an EMP, which he didn't have on before.
Right. So he's mixing up his classes, and that's pretty good to see. You know, players using different classes for different hills on different maps.
Yeah.
Pretty cool stuff to see. So he pops his trip system up and just goes for a little jump, little journey. And this is the best way to
say
it. This Noble team really has impressed me so far. I'm not sure what your thoughts are, but going toe-to-toe with Optic Gaming.
Yeah, they
honestly, wow, it was such a crazy series.
They surprised a lot of people there. You know, I got the chance to interview Crimsix, and he said that Optic didn't play to the best of their abilities. He thought it should have been much more of a blowout, but honestly, Impact just making some clutch plays in SMD that looks fantastic.
Oh.
Obviously, they lost the second one, but that first one was absolute destruction. Optic Gaming got 7 of the 8 first bloods, but Impact wound up winning the SND 6-2, which I've never even seen that before. But there in the kill feed, you see massive slaying there by TK clearing out that hill. Only a 7-point lead here for them. But right now, we're going to see Team Star rotating towards this back garage hardpoint. Nice pickup there by Goon. He's 10-6 at the start of this game.
Goon job playing very well right now. 11-6. And he's been the cause of some concern online.
Yeah.
Come down to some of the big tournaments. You know, you'll hear us talk about that all weekend. But when he comes to LAN, he just does step up. There can be no denying it. Maybe
there have
been some questions about whether he could do it on this game, but he's answered his critics, I feel. You know, he really is playing very, very well, having a solid event. But the player that's impressed me the most is this man. He's currently bottom of his team, Sharp 8-7. But his EXO movement is just
phenomenal.
Uncanny. It's crazy. It's just beautiful to watch at times.
Now, something I wanted to point out there, Ben, Sharp finally gets taken out, but the big thing for this back hill, which Matt was talking about a lot, Mr. X was saying how when you get control of it, you don't want to sit in there. You want to push out, give yourself some lanes, give yourself some sights so you're able to kill people from range.
So
TK was doing that there for a second, but Ben, what were you going to try?
Yeah, I was going to say the reason behind that is actually because of the anchoring position. Normally in the hard points, you think every time you anchor into any hard point, there's a position behind that that you want to hold so you can get the good spawn.
Exactly.
But you just be like, just by being on that hard point, you're essentially anchoring it. It's a very unusual hard point. But the big kind of benefit analysis to that is if you are on that hill, it takes so long to rotate because the next hill, of course, all the way to the other side, which is exactly where the other team is set up.
As you can see there on the map, full control of the next hard point here from the Noble Impact squad, but two of them go down. The final two are in the hill. Are they able to pick up any kills? Let's see here. And Spacey's going to get pushed from Pipes. Picks up one. Now dodging to the right. Great use of that EXO movement there, but gets taken out. Great work there by TK to be able to break that. And that's the thing that we keep mentioning, Ben, is that the differences in hard point in this and Black Ops 2. In Black Ops 2, they just had a perfect setup. It would have taken so much skill to break that and actually get through it. But instead, in this game, you could just keep flooding it and flooding it until you break it. Right now, every member of TK positive. That's great to see if you're a fan of Team Calum.
Oh, absolutely. But the big thing, again, is Goonja, man. He's heating up 21
Double
and 11.
Positive.
Yeah, he's really playing very well. Unfortunately, Looney goes down. Theory, though, on the hill. 10-9. We saw some crazy stuff from him yesterday. Honestly, their series against Optic Gaming was kind of unsurprised, to be honest with you. Like, I didn't see that coming at all. I'm going to be completely honest with you. I thought they would have got steamrolled. But I had a chance to catch up with Koz, one of the owners of Team Calibur, and we had a good chat. And he's saying, yeah, he expected this. He expected Team Calibur to be this good, you know. And not in like a delusional owner of a team way,
yeah.
But in a genuine realistic, like he anticipated them to be so good. He said that, you know, the similarities to this game, Black Ops 2, think about how good TK were on Black Ops 2.
Oh, you know? Yeah.
They were in the grand final of so many events, so he said this is no surprise for him.
Yeah, it's great to see Team Caliber coming back into form here in Advanced Warfare. That match definitely shocked everybody there, and if I'm not mistaken, right now they're on the top of Pool A, sitting at 2-0, if I'm not mistaken, so this match here could basically seal their first winner's yeah. bracket victory.
Actually, would.
So here we see right now Study trying to break this hill, gets taken out. Miracles struggling to say the least at 7-17. And I feel like that's the issue with this Noble Impact squad, where sometimes when they're firing on all cylinders and keeping even in slaying, they're doing great. But here they're just getting outslayed completely, now down by 70. The difference maker in that series versus Optic Gaming, especially in the hard point, was that at one point all of them were negative. They wound up turning it around, having a few of them go positive because of so many kills. And they wound up coming back, and that hard point was so close. Even though they wound up losing it, they showed a great amount of skill there in that game one.
Right. And I'm just looking at Miracles, 11-18. Like, that's interesting considering how well he was playing in that last series.
Yeah.
So all of a sudden you just kind of get like iced. I know they waited quite a while before this game actually started. A couple of players went out to try and grab some food, obviously lunchtime kind of passing, and they were in the middle of the series. So
yeah.
They were a tad peckish, I think is
that makes sense.
To say.
I'm yeah. a big guy, I understand food, Ben, but as you can see there, Mir still struggling here. You know, he had some crazy plays in Search and Destroy that last series. I think he had like 4 1v1 clutches as well as a 1v3 between the two games.
Yes, he did.
Absolutely incredible. Now, as you can see here, the lead getting larger and larger for this TK squad. I mean, I'm going to be honest here, Ben. I expected this to happen here in Game 1, but if there's any map that they can come back in, it's going to be Game 2 where we're going to see Search and Destroy on Biolab after this, but you know Noble wants to take this map 1.
Oh, I mean, of course. If Noble takes map 1, that puts him in such a good position because, you know, I feel like you have to kind of favor them in Search and Destroy.
Wow.
Devin, no! Don't you dare, Goonjar.
Stop that right now.
Right. Bad Goonjar. No. Think about what you just did, Goonjar. Right. Yeah, essentially. Like, that was... See, that's the thing about TK. Like, they can just do moments like that where it's just... It'll blow you mind.
And you know Sharp in the booth is getting ridiculously hyped.
He's not there anymore. He's just hiding there.
Oh, okay. That is hiding.
Yeah.
I was like, Sharp's not on TK anymore. You scared me for a second. Goon just picked up 2 more. The guy is flying all over the place, making plays happen right now. TK still up by 50 points. Every member of Team Caliber still positive. If we do some quick math here, they are positive 15 right now over this Impact squad. That is not a good position
to be in. Do you think Team Caliber could beat Noble at Search and Destroy?
Oh, honestly, if they take this map 1 and have the momentum, yeah. Like, Noble looks very good, but they also had a lot of plays that, while it may have been a lot of skill, they also had some luck involved in,
right.
in S&D. No, there was a lot of great COD timing for them in that Optic Gaming S&D, and honestly, both of them, with Killa popping out right as Scum planted that bomb. Now, I'm not taking anything away from them, as obviously they're one of the best S&D teams in the game.
Right.
But if anyone can do it, it's TK, because they want to prove this weekend that they are a top-notch squad and that the Looney pickup was the right thing to do.
And everyone kind of underestimated them as well. That was the big thing. No one had them in the top 8. But that's kind of what TK like.
Oh, they love it.
TK love the underdog story. As soon as they get favored, it's kind of like they just get a little bit nervous and kind of cack it, to be really honest with you.
Yeah. I mean, we mentioned it a few times this game, guys, but Goon just hit 40 kills.
Is he on 40
he's
already?
Now 41
oh,
and 25.
Lord.
I'd love to hop on board with him. Now he's up by 70
Does
seconds.
Does he hit 50 kills?
This wonderful bearded man doing incredible things here on a 4-kill streak. Now he knows they got to go break this next hill. They're going to push up this pipe side, picks up one, gets the
okay.
other. Goon right. is playing out of his mind, ladies and gentlemen.
Is he going to hit 50? Yes or no?
Yeah. Oh, easily. 2 minutes mm-hmm. left, and he needs 6 kills.
206 points, though.
Five kills.
The problem is 4 kills.
He's sorry. Putting on a show.
Like, what? Oh my God!
He's killing everything in sight.
His teammates. Like, Goon, stop it, man. You need your teammates. I know it's a one-man show right now, but don't be killing them, man.
The TK owners were about to be like,
oh!
My God!
Haymaker!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your MLG Top 5 play.
Yeah, right?
I think that's what we're seeing right here.
This is a 10 streak right now.
He's behind all the players.
Oh, no, it's 11.
11. This is absolutely incredible.
2 more kills.
This is like when your Chef Boyardee is nice and warm when you go to eat it. 12 streak.
Make it.
Stop it right now.
Oh, Goon, nearly.
Stop that right now. 49.
So close to that 50
He's 49 and 25, Benson. That's better at anything that I've ever done in my entire life.
That's And that's like my score combined on a whole best of five series right
there.
They're
up 100 points but now. Goonjar is absolutely dominating. He's making Noble Impact feel like little kids.
Oh,
honestly, right now, Goon is probably the next pickup for Team Heckleberry, the team of the 8-year-olds. But here we see the final hill going to rotate here. TK only 4 points away from winning. That is the explosive start you want here in map 1.
Oh, yeah, and that's what we're talking about Goonjar at the start. You know, he's a player who can just do that.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what he did. And what was kind of a semi-close game just got turned into
a blowout.
Yeah, complete blowout. Over
109 point difference. There you have it,
that's
guys.
That's just crazy.
There
dude.
You see him on your screen, dapping each other up. Amazing work there from Goon and the rest of that squad. Goonjar dropping 50 kills and 29 deaths, an MVP performance if I would ever see one. And you can see there, not many caps, but knowing his teammates will cap.
Like that matters.
Yeah.
When you're killing everything that moves, you don't even need to be on the hill.
Absolutely incredible.
Just let your teammates just lie there and just be like, okay. Especially when Looney has 10. And was that Theory with 10
too? They both, 10, 10, and 6. Well, there you see, guys, Noble Impact, every single player on that squad going negative. That is not how they want to start things off, especially since they're not known as the best slaying team. But Ben, we're going to be hopping into Search and Destroy here. Round predictions. Who's going to win?
TK.
He didn't give me the rounds, guys.
No,
I don't even care because you know what? We're going to go to a quick commercial break. When we come back, we're going to see if TK can pull out the win.